touch my hair.
What's up, YouTube? It's your girl Shanti and Nicole back with another one. Today, guys, we're just gonna have us a little chitty chat about just natural hair in general. I'm calling this the need to know about natural hair because I get asked so many questions on how is my hair growing so fast? What products am I using? What to do for this, that, and the third, and it's just like very simple, guys. Like being natural, some people think it's like a chore, but it's really not. I mean, it can be if you don't have a routine, if you don't know your hair, if you don't know what your hair likes, it can be like oh my god. But you, especially also when you're passionate about your natural hair, like myself, I'm very passionate about my natural hair, so me doing my hair, it's not like one of those oh my god type feelings. Washing it sometimes, yes, but overall, once I'm in the shower and I'm washing it, I'm happy, you know what I mean? Because I literally started from nothing. I cut my hair off and then boom, here I am now. But we'll talk about that another day. But so I just want to get into like the need to knows, the really need to knows about natural hair and how your hair can flourish. And literally, I only have three things that I personally feel will help your hair to flourish, because mostly your hair is going to grow based off your genes, your genetics, so your parents, your grandparents, your aunts, your uncles, it's all genetic. So that's to me the biggest factor. But I'm gonna say my top three outside of the genes, because that's just common knowledge. But one of the main things that I feel like you should know in order for your hair to flourish, one thing is you should keep your scalp cleansed. Like, your scalp should not have cakey buildup, and I suffer from dry scalp. It's getting better because I'm washing frequently because I have more time now. So I'm cleansing my scalp more and I'm noticing less dry scalp, and my hair is growing just a little bit more. I'm noticing it, like I need to trim my ends like today. Because my hair is growing so much because I'm cleansed and I'm keeping the scalp cleansed. You know, it's not itching, it's not as dry as it usually or like it used to be. So that's number one. I would say you need to wash your hair as frequent as possible, but not overwash it. So don't go washing every day. But then again, it just depends on your hair and your hair needs and how much time you have. At this point, I'm currently washing my hair literally every week now, or sometimes every other, whereas I used to go 2 weeks and then wash it, then 2 more weeks and then wash it. But now I have time. So your girl's washing her hair every week. And then I'm trying new products, recording videos. And so my hair is getting that like product buildup feel, and I don't like that. And when I do certain things or put certain products in my hair, and I'm like taking my twists and stuff down, once I see all those white like flakes and particles from the product, it's time to wash it. So that's number one. I would say keep your scalp cleansed like as much as possible. Number two, I would say to keep your ends trimmed. Like that is so important. People think that, oh, my hair is like really, really long and I don't want to trim my ends. Okay, well, you're damaging your hair and you're hurting yourself more, because if you go without trimming your ends, and I wouldn't say there's a specific time, you should know when it's time to trim your ends or dust your ends. For me specifically, I notice when I'm detangling my hair, whether I'm finger detangle or using my wide tooth comb or my knockoff Dollar Holla tangle teaser, I notice how the ends, when the brush of the comb or my fingers or that tangle teaser gets to the end, how it gets caught and it's like really dry. And I'm noticing my hair sheds a lot more. Like when I take it down, it's shedding on me. It's shedding in the sink. So that to me, for me specifically, that lets me know, okay, it's time to trim. So it's like, what are we doing? So that's one thing that I noticed with my hair. I have to keep my scalp cleansed for it to flourish. And then two, I have to keep my ends trimmed, because if I don't, then my hair is going to eventually start splitting and breaking, and that's just going to cause damage, and you're going to eventually have to cut all your hair off. Not really cut all your hair off, but if you go so long without a trim or a dusting, your hair, yes, is growing, but then you forget you get those split ends, so letting it just grow. Those split ends are gonna go up the healthy hair shaft of your hair, and guess what, girl? Your hair is damaged, so you're gonna need to cut more than you would have had to cut had you just trimmed your ends, okay? So that's number two. And then the third thing that I'm gonna say is a need to know is that you need to just keep your hair moisturized, okay? And products don't so much moisturize your hair. I mean, they give you that moisturized feeling, but if you're keeping your scalp clean and you're trimming your ends and you're using a little bit of product, and be sure to use some water, like even in the morning, when you wake up, you take your hair down, or just before any type of styling you're getting ready to do, please spritz your hair with water, okay? How much depends on you. I don't like to drench my hair with certain styles because then it'll shrink and revert, and I like a little bit of hang time, you know what I mean? But if I don't get that, that's fine. It just depends on how dry my hair feels. If it's like severely dry because I haven't touched it in a few days, or I'm going in with my spray bottle. But typically when I do my hair, I always spritz it first with water, then I go in with a liquid oil and cream, which is the lock method. Y'all should know that already. I have a video on that. Check that out if you have not. But yeah, I would definitely say you need to keep your hair moisturized as much as possible, and probably just keep it really simple with the moisturization part. Like for me, I'm at the point where I'm just a leave-in conditioner type of girl. Like, I can literally spritz my hair with some water, put a little oil in my hands, rub it in my hair, and then use a leave-in, and I can do a bomb-ass braid-out, twist-out, flat twist, which this was a flat twist. And I did use that swab line that I used in my other video. I used their leave-in and their curl cream, and this is what I got. I did the flat twist, kept them up for 2 days, and I literally took them down today. So, my hair feels really, really moisturized, and I like the definition, so I'm trying to keep my hands out so that I keep this definition. But overall, make sure your hair is moisturized. So again, let's go over this again. Top three need to knows for natural hair, okay? Keep your scalp cleansed, keep your ends or your hair trimmed, and keep your hair moisturized. Don't let it go so many days without you moisturizing. Even if you don't really feel like styling and doing it, just simply go in that bathroom and spritz your head on with some water, get a little bit of leave-in, put it all over, and throw it up in a puff. Just get some ends moisturized, and just take care of your hair, ladies. Like, that's how your hair is gonna grow. Like, before all other things, I mean, of course, your genes, but those are like the three things that I will say, because people always assume that products make your hair grow. No, girl, them products is just sitting on top of your hair and giving you like a moisturized feel, and they do kind of moisturize your hair too, but you also gotta remember intake, what you're eating, what you're putting in your body plays a lot on your skin and on your hair. That's another thing. But mainly, like I said, if you keep your scalp clean, you keep your ends trimmed, you keep your hair moisturized, girl, guess what? Your hair will flourish, okay? So those are basically my three need to knows, okay, about natural hair. And I'm gonna specifically say type 4 hair, okay, because I feel like in our community, we don't have a lot of people educating us on our hair. You know, they wanna generalize and put us all in one category. You cannot, because all of our hairs are different. Even if we're all in the type 4, I have type 4 hair, but I have some 3 in my hair. You know, I got maybe some 4C, I'm 4B, but I feel like I may have a little bit of 4C, and I got some 3 up in here, okay? Because I noticed some of my hair, when I put certain product, how like I have a looser texture on this side specifically. This was the more kinkier side, but whatever. I love my hair in general, so it doesn't bother me. But again, make sure you are cleansing your scalp. I now shampoo and condition again. Co-washing, I don't do so much because, like I say, I need to get my scalp as clean as possible. And now I feel like when I co-wash, I don't feel like my scalp is really getting the cleansing it needs. And that's just me, it's personal preference. But I am shampooing and conditioning, and I have started deep conditioning. Check that video out also. I am deep conditioning a lot more, so I'm noticing that's helping. But I am due for a trimming, and I do need to get on it ASAP. But again, y'all, that's it. I just wanted to let y'all know my three need to knows. I hope this helps someone, because I'm always getting asked, what do I do? What do you do to make your hair grow? There's no specific product that I'm using, honestly, because I'm using so many products. You know what I mean? I can tell you if it worked for me or if it didn't. But ultimately, keep that scalp clean, keep the ends trimmed, and yes, moisturizing. I mean, with water and everything else. Not just go buy a product and slap it on your hair. No, girl, make sure you keep it moisturized, wet it with a little bit of water or aloe vera juice, whichever, you know? So that's it, y'all. That's all for today's video. I hope you guys enjoy. If you have any questions, comment down below. Your girl, she talks back. Let the world know Shantia Nicole, she has arrived. And if you are not subscribed and you made it this far, what are we doing? Go ahead and hit that subscribe button, like, comment, and share. I would really appreciate that. Follow me on my social media at Shantia_Nicole. I follow back. If you need to DM me, I talk back. And that's it for today, y'all. As always, peace and blessings.